Hi guys, welcome to a new video from Masters of Consulting. As you see in this video, Masa is back again. So this video is all about her masters, how she did her masters and how she got to the point of getting the admit. And actually me and her, we did the masters in the same university. So this university is called Hochschule Offenburg. So this is towards the southwest of Germany. It's one of the hottest region in Germany. So yeah, so let's ask her some few questions after the intro. Hi Masa, how are you doing?
Hi. Very good, thank you for asking.
Okay, so can you explain us how you got to point of getting the admission, and why did you especially choose this university, and what things do you find good in this university?
So the process of the admission, it's pretty much like other universities in Germany. You need your language certificate, IELTS, I think it's 6 or 6.5, and you need your credits translation, your marks from your school, from back in the school, and then just posting the admission. So I've got to know this university from the website daad.de. So when I was going through the profile, I saw it is matching the subject that I had for my bachelor, and the university also really sounds nice. I went through some reviews. It was one of the top 10 international courses in the Germany, so that was really nice. And also the courses were in English, which I was really looking for. That I was looking for this special option because I didn't want to study in German. So these were the reason that I chose this university. And I think maybe most of the people knows in Germany we have Universität and Hochschule. The difference is the Hochschule is more practical, so we had more practical courses compared to the Universität, which is more theoretical. So I chose also Hochschule because of that, because I believe with practical courses you learn better.
Yeah, yeah, I think this is one of the important thing actually, the difference between Hochschule and TUs, technical universities. So technical universities, as she told, are more theoretical, and it's more for PhDs and doing more research, but Hochschule is more like a practical based. Okay, that's awesome, Masa. Like, so you got your admit, and what happened with your visa, and how did it work after that?
So when I applied, it was almost 5 years ago. I booked some appointment and I did interview for my visa, and it didn't take long, but now the process is much longer in Iran that I know. I don't know about the other countries. So I just waited for my visa. When it came, that was it, everything was ready for me to come. The good thing about Hochschule Offenburg was they will consider a buddy for you that would be one of the senior students, which is studying already in the Hochschule. So that person will be responsible for you. So I could ask many questions. For example, what do I need to bring with myself, or what is it like there, how is the university, how is the city, and that person will answer your questions. When you reach Offenburg, the person will come, pick you up, take you to your home, and after that for your bank, for your insurance, for everything else's, city registration, the person will help you going through that process, which I found it really helpful.
Yeah, even I think this buddy program makes a lot of improvement, because you know you are in a different country and you really actually don't know what is happening, so you have lots of questions, of course. So this buddy is actually really helpful in this phase. So what was your first impression when you came to this city of Offenburg, or should I call it as a village?
So if you want me to be honest, my first impression wasn't really good, because the city is not really big, as you know. It's a very small city, so I was imagining something more from Germany that I reach. Okay, it would be wow, but it's a really small city. One disadvantage that we had, we didn't have the card.
The student card, which you get for every month for the public transport.
Exactly. So as I know, all the universities, you will be allowed to use the public transport with your student card free of charge, but it wasn't like that here. So, but the good point about Offenburg was it's really small, so we really didn't need to use the public transport. Everybody in the Hochschule were using cycle, and you needed only maybe 10 minutes, 15 minutes to reach any places that you had in your mind. So that is one advantage about the city. But as I said, at first I was disappointed, but by going through the time, I got to know that being in a small city has lots of advantages. For example, for me as a student, it was much cheaper compared to the bigger cities, especially rent. And also you will find friends more easily. It's really easy to find good friends because the sociality, the people, they are not that much. So when you go to the city, you will know almost everybody. And about the university, I can say it was amazing. The university provides many trips. I remember the first thing that they did, they took everybody to Lake Constance, and we stayed there for 2 or 3 days. We had so much fun there together. We got to know each other. We got to know our cultures, my classmates, and it was awesome.
Yeah, so that's one important thing, as you mentioned, also is people knows everyone there, so everyone knows everyone, so it's like a small family in this city. And also the good thing is the nature, which is also around, and it's surrounded by beautiful Schwarzwald, which is called Black Forest, and it's really beautiful to take a hike. Okay, that's fine, Master. So how is the infrastructure, and how do you say about the opportunities what you got after you got into this university?
I got many opportunities, to be honest. I think in Germany it's important in what university you study, but it's more important how many experience, or it's about your talent, what you know. That's really important. So as soon as I got graduated, even before that, I got an offer, and I moved to München for my full-time job. So I can say it's really amazing. The courses, it was really helpful for me, the university, and they gave this opportunity to work for my master thesis as full-time in one startup, which also that gave me lots of experiments, which helped me now to find another job. So I think, yeah, it was really great.
Can you say two words or two sentences about your course? So this is Masters in Communication and Media Engineering. So how would you explain to this to someone out there who has no idea about what it is?
I can say this course was divided into
two parts.
Yeah, exactly. Two fields, electronic and IT. Mm-hmm. And the good thing was, you were almost able to choose the path that you wanted to take, because some courses were optional, some were compulsory. So I can say for me that I wanted to choose IT, I could choose the related ones. Mm-hmm. And for whoever wanted media, there were also courses related to that, and electronic also another part. So we were like people with different backgrounds. And the good part was, for example, when it was about electronic, other people who had the good background in electronic were helping the IT people, and IT people were helping the others for programming and everything else. So the community, it was perfect. For each exam, everybody were sitting together, were helping each other, and we were going through that all together. And I never felt any difficulties, to be honest. Maybe some part, but It was great. I learned a lot, especially from our practical courses. We had lots of labs, which we had to do projects, like really working on it. And yeah, I can say I learned a lot from that.
Perfect. So it's really great that how you explain everything in detail. That's awesome. I'm sure it's helpful for the people out there. So in few words, for people who are right now looking and thinking, should I really go to Offenburg University in the first place, or also some course like Masters in Communication and Media Engineering? What would your suggestions be for them?
I say it's a great opportunity. For me it was, and I found lots of good friends, which they became like my family right now. The courses, the Hochschule, everything was perfect, especially the people were working there. They were super kind, super helpful, and yeah, I think I suggest that. And even though it's a very small city, you can find job very easily. It can be not related to your field, or it can, for example, I was working in a university for one of my professors, so job is there. The city is small and cheap, so you will have the opportunity to learn and also earn some money.
And also I think after you leave that city, when you come to big cities, you have this feeling like, hey, I'm in a big city now. And I think somehow it is quite nice to experience the nature first time and then coming to a big city. I found it the same. So yeah, thanks a lot, Masa, for coming and giving your wisdom. I'm sure it has been helpful for a lot of people out there. Guys, so Tali Bajao, so claps for Masa, thanks a lot. And as always, if you like the video, please make sure you like, share and subscribe. And yeah, please stay safe in this pandemic times, and until next time, see you.